آله وأصحابه، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Welcome brothers and sisters, the weekly حلقة, weekly class, explaining كتاب التوحيد, written by Shaykh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab al-Tamimi. And as an introduction, I like to mention that the Shaykh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah ta'ala, we spoke about his biography in very summarized biography. And if you like, you can find detailed books about his life, rahimahullah ta'ala. No doubt, Shaykh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, one of the great scholars, no doubt. And I like in this introduction to mention the point that when you hear or when you read or when you watch something against Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah ta'ala, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, Muawiyah radiyallahu ta'ala, and one of the great companions, even the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, if the person is not Muslim. Number one, you have to be fair when you read, when you listen, when you watch. What is the problem, brothers and sisters? Many times, some Muslims, or many Muslims, they have an issue toward the companion Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Why? Because they say, or they read, or they hear some da'i say, yes, Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala was fighting the great Khalifa Ali ibn Abi Talib, the cousin of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was fighting him and he did not give him the Khilafah. He was doing this and that. So emotionally, they will attract the hearts of some Muslims who don't have knowledge to love Ali radiallahu ta'ala and to hate or dislike Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala. And this is dangerous, brothers and sisters. Especially and specifically the companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum. So you should know who is Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhum before knowing the battle or what happened between Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhum and Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhum, or what happened between Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhum and Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Zubair, Talha with Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, or what happened between Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and Fatima radiallahu ta'ala and the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have to be careful. You should know from the beginning who is Muawiyah. Who is Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu? So what is the point now? Many Muslims jump years and they come to the point in the year 34 or 35 or 36 after the Hijrah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what happened in the battle of Siffin. Then they accuse Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala and they mention some hadith. This is not the correct way. You should know who is Muawiyah from the beginning. Yes, Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala did not accept Islam from the beginning. He was not with Abu Bakr. I mean this group, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an, Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, Abu Ubaidah, Amr al-Jarrah, Abdul Rahman al-Awf. And also he was not with the group of Umar al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, who came after Abu Bakr and Uthman radiallahu ta'ala, but still before the migration. And also he was not with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the beginning of the Hijrah time, the Madani time. He accepted Islam maybe after 17 or after 20 years of the da'wah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he accepted Islam, he was one of the great companions. He was one of the companions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was trusting him to write al-wahi. It is common, there is a term called kuttab al-wahi. What does it mean kuttab al-wahi? Those companions who were writing the revelation, who were writing the Quran. So do you know what is the meaning or what is the honor that was given to Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala an, to write the wahi in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala an was the leader of Sham, even from the time, yani before Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. And he did a great job. Even after the death of Ali, or the killing of Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. So you should know who is Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala an. Then you realize the position of Muawiyah in Islam. So if you hear, after knowing who is Muawiyah from the beginning of his Islam and what is the relationship between him and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the other companions, then if something happened after 30 years of the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or 25 years, you will realize, okay, maybe this is a mistake or not. And if it is a mistake, as Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah said, فَهِيَ مَغْمُورَ فِي بِحَارِ حَسَنَاتِهِمْ, it will be covered by the seas of the reward, of their reward. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Okay, so this is about Muawiyah, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So when you come to Shaykh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, okay, those who now, not only now, from his time, I mean before 200 years, okay, or before 300 years, they were fighting Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab and refuting him and replying, replying on their books and his da'wah, okay? Before believing them or listening to them, you should know who is Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah. Where he grew, and yani, was he looking for the leadership to be a ruler for the Muslim Ummah? Is it true that he was killing the Muslims and he was telling his friends, go and kill the Muslims? Of course, it is common, yani, subhanAllah, that Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab saying takfir for the Muslims and shirk for the Muslims, what, yani, and without excusing them, even if there is an excuse, subhanAllah. And he himself, rahimahullah ta'ala, mentioned, okay, I'm not giving takfir for the Muslims with his ignorance. And there is an important point, brothers and sisters. Now, I mentioned this many times. If you read in the Quran, or in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For example, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يدخل جنة قاطع. لا يدخل جنة قاطع. What's mean قاطع? The one who doesn't, the one who cuts his relationship with his cousins and relatives. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he will not enter paradise. Another hadith, لا يدخل جنة قتات. نمام, slanderer. It is one kind of backbiting. So if you take this hadith, then you say, what is this? Islam is a very bad religion. If I backbite or I do slandering, then I am not Muslim, I'll be in hellfire? No, you should understand. You should understand the hadith. The hadith means it is a major sin, but he is Muslim. So he will be under the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he wills, he will punish him, then he will be in paradise. Or Allah will forgive him this sin, then he will put him in paradise directly. Okay, from where I brought this conclusion? Because of other proofs from the Quran and Sunnah. Because in another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَا يَشَاءَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive shirk. While he will forgive what is less than shirk, if he wills, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So by this way, we can understand Islam in the proper way. You have to collect all the proofs from the Quran, from the authentic Sunnah, and how the scholars explain these ahadith and these verses. So the same thing, some people, deviant people, subhanAllah, with bad intention or ignorance, they take one word, they go, they open Kitab Tawheed, here the Shaykh said, he is kafir, the one who's doing this, he is kafir, he is mushrik, he'll be in the hellfire, we should kill him, and we can't take his wealth. Subhanallah. This is not the way, the correct way of knowledge. It's not the correct way of seeking knowledge. You should be careful. You should understand what are the terms of the scholars? You should read the other books. Okay, maybe sometimes he will mention something summarized. In another way, he will make it clear. As we mentioned, the halqa last week, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned there are ayat muhkamat, hunna umul kitab, wa akhar mutashabihat. In the Quran, there are verses, some verses muhkam and the others mutashabih. Muhkam, one of the opinions, muhkam means it is clear. When you read the ayah, you can understand it clearly. And you don't need another ayah to understand it or another hadith to understand it. Khalas. Allah says, wa aqimu salah. Khalas, I understand from the ayah, it is wajib, it is compulsory to establish salah. That's it. Wa huwa as-sami'u al-basir. Allah is the hearer, the most hearer, the most seer. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Khalas, this is clear. But sometimes mutashabihat. Yeah, and for example, and I gave the example, and Zalakhir, I mentioned Surah Al-Naba, but it is actually in Surah Al-Nazi'at. One of the brothers told me, it was a mistake from me. وَالْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ دَحَاهَا أَخْرَجَ مِنْهَا مَاءَهَا وَمَرْعَاهَا. What does it mean, دَحَاهَا? So this mutashabihat. I cannot understand this ayah directly. But if I read the next ayah, I can understand this. So mutashabih, something not clear by itself, but you need another ayah to understand. Like the ayah we mentioned in this kitab, Kitab al-Tawheed, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Those who believed, and they do not mix with their belief any ظُلْم. What's mean ظُلْم? Wrongdoing, oppression. So the companion said, oh Rasulullah, everyone oppresses himself. Maybe I say a bad word, I see something haram, I hear something haram. We do this. Then the Prophet ﷺ explained this. He said, you did not read the other ayah? يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. So the Prophet ﷺ explained the hadith, sorry, this ayah, by another ayah, that the dhulm here, the oppression here, means shirk. So this is the point, brothers, sisters. So, yani, why I'm giving this? Because yani, someone sent me a very long lecture of one of the da'iyah in America. More than, I think, 3 hours. Okay, just to prove that Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahab is following the wrong way. And the Daesh, the ISIS, are using the books of Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahab, the fatwa of Muhammad Abdul Wahab, to make takfir for the Muslims. Subhanallah. And yani, wallahi, yani, this is strange. I told this brother, Zal Akhir, I was discussing with him. One of the signs to show you that, like, these da'iyah are deviant da'iyah with bad intention, of course, yani, we are not sure about what is inside the heart. Yani, we cannot make sure what is inside the heart. But I mean, there are signs. So if you notice the person, this da'iyah, attacking Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, Muhammad Abdul Wahab, Ibn Uthaymeen, Al-Albani, Ibn Baz, he's only attacking the Salafi scholars. And you will not find one lecture or one book talking about the Ikhwani people, or the Ash'ari, or the Sufi, or Maturidi. Okay? So now there is a question mark. Why you put your effort against, only against the Salafi scholars and the Salafi methodology? And you don't speak about the clear deviancy, like the Sufi, who go to the graves and they ask the people in the graves, oh no, this is not shirk. This is a sin, but this is not shirk. Tayyib, you should be careful. As we mentioned last week, the saying by Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu ta'ala, حَدِّثُ النَّاسِ بِمَا عَرِفُونَ. Okay, speak at the same level of people. Because, okay, what is the meaning? I tell people, this is not shirk.
Ah,
there's no shirk, خلاص. Okay, so I'll do this. It is a sin, but Allah will forgive this. You should tell them, this is haram, don't do this. Allah mentioned the Quran, this is haram. And there are hadith warning not to do that. يعني my point, brothers and sisters, we are in a position, we should stop people from doing the major sins and the shirk, not to find an excuse for them. And we show them, wallah, there are different opinions. And we should be careful, brothers and sisters. Not any opinion, not any controversial, is accepted. I mean, if there is an issue, fiqh issue, aqidah issue, okay, there are two opinions. Some people think, if there are two opinions, then it's okay for me to take any one of the opinions. For example, if there are two opinions about the hijab for the woman. One opinion said, hijab is fard, compulsory. And if the woman doesn't have hijab, then she is a sinner. The other opinion, no, this is mustahab, highly recommended, but if she doesn't wear the hijab, then she is not doing sin. So some people think, okay, there is two opinions, so it's okay. If I take this opinion or that opinion, it's okay. No. And this situation is not okay. Why? Because the second opinion, which says that the hijab, okay, I'm giving an example. Okay, an example. The hijab is fard, definitely, no doubt. It is fard. Okay, there is different opinions about the niqab, covering the face. So, those who say, if there are people who say, the hijab is only mustahab, not wajib, we should not accept that. We should not accept that. Why? Because this kind of difference is not accepted. Like, if there is a person, there is a person who said, the khamr is not haram. Why? Because Allah did not say haram. Subhanallah. Wallahi, yani, you'll find crazy da'i. Nowadays, you'll find crazy da'i. Crazy sheikh, may Allah protect us. And may Allah protect the Muslim ummah. Brothers and sisters, we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the guidance. We should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qulubana ala dinik. We should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us on the Islam until death. Fitna, wallahi. Sometimes the fitna, this tribe, because of money, because of a nationality, because of a wife, because of children. May Allah protect us. Subhanallah. So, back to the point. We should know who is Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah. Now, I'm not going to explain, talk about the biography of Muhammad Abdul Wahhab. But those who think that Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab was wrong in his da'wah, and those who think that Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab is the head of the Takfiri people of the ISIS, you are, you should not be hurry. Be careful. Go and read the biography of Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab and check his books. And check the students who were with him in his country. And don't listen to someone who claims, I know all the books of Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, or I'm the most knowledgeable person about his books. Okay? What kind of arrogance is this? May Allah protect us. Okay? No doubt. You can't say, wallah, I read, for example, 40 books of Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab. Say that. But you say, I am the most knowledgeable person. That's not acceptable. Why? Because you don't know. You don't know how many students of Sheikh Muhammad Wahhab there are. Brother, sister, you know, in some of the areas, before maybe 100 years and 200 years, people memorize the books or some of the books of Sheikh Muhammad Wahhab, rahimahullah ta'ala, in the masjid. They memorize the books. Yeah, for example, Kitab Tawheed, they memorize Kitab Tawheed. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وقول الله تعالى وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون، وقول الله تعالى ولقد بعثنا في كل أمة رسولا أن اعبدوا الله واجتنبوا الطاغوت. Then they mentioned the second eye, third eye, fourth eye. Then the hadith قال عن معاذ بن جبل رضي الله تعالى عنه كنت رديف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم and they memorize. Then someone comes here or not here in America and he says and he claims I'm the most knowledgeable person. He doesn't know. يعني I cannot say والله he is the most knowledgeable person or not. Because we don't know who are the students of Sheikh Muhammad al-Wahhab and how many people did the study and research. And don't listen to the one who's taking the advantage that he knows Arabic and you don't know Arabic. Because you don't know Arabic, خلاص. I master the people who are in the West. Because they don't know Arabic. And whatever I tell them, they will listen. Why? Because they cannot go and check behind me. Brothers, sisters, the issue is not a personal issue between me and that da'i or the other da'iya. Okay? The issue is the haqq, the truth. The issue is we need to protect the Muslim ummah from shirk. This is the worst sin. The worst sin, shirk. We need to protect the Muslim ummah from shirk. And you can't see how many people do shirk. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثَرٌ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا هُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. Most of people who believe in Allah, they have shirk. Most of people are mushrik. Most of people, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ تُلُّكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Most of the people will misguide you from the straight path, from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to read from the Quran and authentic Sunnah. We need to trust our scholars. They are not ma'soom. They are not sinless. Definitely. Sheikh Al-Albani, Ibn Baz, Ibn Abdul-Wahhab. They have mistakes. Yes, they have mistakes. But I'm talking about the methodology and also I'm talking about be fair. And don't give your mind to people who يعني speak and يعني many times I'm saying this in English and they can speak in Arabic but they are not speaking Arabic. Many times I mentioned this point. Okay, I believe in this point. Those kind of people don't speak in Arabic because they are sure if they speak in Arabic. Yeah, for example, this lecture, 3 hours. If he made this lecture in Arabic, many refutation. He will lose his fame. If he does this in Arabic. Wallahu a'lam. طيب. طيب. Let's continue. Kitab al-Tawheed. And also, يعني, brothers, sisters, يعني, you notice, if there is not authentic hadith, we mention, well, this hadith is not authentic by Sheikh Al-Albani, by the other scholars. Okay, this hadith is controversial hadith. Okay, so if there is something we think this is not agreed upon, we mention this. With full respect to Sheikh Al-Albani, Sheikh Muhammad Ibn Lahab, and also Sheikh Al-Albani, rahimahullah ta'ala. So this is the way of the Salaf. خلاص, they take knowledge from the previous generation. But they will not take it blindly. They will take it with full respect. If it is supported by the authentic hadith, خلاص, they will take it. But if it is not supported by authentic hadith, but not by the Quran, خلاص, they will say maybe this scholar has an excuse. خلاص.